And it was a Pishat Pope, they quoted you up on your video. Oh, about right, how yeah. Like our odds, 6 million people, and most of us are good people.
Yeah, well, it's true, isn't it? I mean, the people causing the problem, there's tiny, tiny number of people.
But the thing I think it means out like we need to do more around Drew's Peak. We let that go.
Well, no one believe you got some no. information on it.
I got his registration number, yeah. We're just working out at the manor how to get.
Judges are shitting themselves at the moment. Absolutely.
Well, you spoke to Lance, didn't you?
I spoke to him a couple of days ago.
Yeah. Well, he showed me his paperwork that was pre-writing the birth in it.
Right.
But he was arranging to go and arrest the councillors at the council offices.
Right.
Get out, you're fired, sort of thing. Well, if we'd have followed up on the birth in it and done actually got the judge arresting him and he'd taken him into a police station and handed him over,
yeah.
They would all,
you know,
yeah.
You know. Everything's done on a wing and a prayer.
If one of
it?
Us
yeah.
stands up above the rest,
yeah.
we're the first to lose our
yeah.
head.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So he was the one that we aimed at that, but we didn't fire the shot sort
well,
of thing.
I'd just say we didn't follow it through the right. Yeah. There was all sorts of reasons, and it's a miracle the thing happened anyway. But it's got the result. We've seen it in the family courts, going on at the family courts, and the judges are shitting themselves. They're still making decisions, they're still taking the children, but you see them. One of the court cases in South Wales, we were saying to the judge, if this child dies, you will be responsible. We said it in court. See, Birkenheads has done the job because the message has gone out there. The people on the streets, the police are talking. Police are ringing up with information now.
Mm. Yeah, he said you were getting
yeah.
a lot of phone
yeah.
calls.
Yeah. This is the thing. The dynamic's been created, and now things are starting to happen.
There's
a few,
I think it's crazy. The NLP training that's going on.
Well, that is you know one of the most dangerous things because
well,
people can't see.
I noticed
yeah.
it like
yeah.
after I got searched by the police.
Yeah.
NLP.
NLP, yeah, basically.
The
police searched me and, tried to search me, and then the inspector came down. He ended up being about 15, 20 copies down.
Yeah.
And I was saying to the inspector, so what's his reasonable grounds? He said, I'll go and find out. So he came back and said, look, yeah, your mate turned up with a broom and a shovel. And I said, right, let's stop talking about me, mate. Let's talk about me. What was he? These reasonable grounds, guys, I don't want to escalate it any further. It's all right, let me go and shake his hand and let him know there's no hard feelings. So I've gone over there, shook him by the hand, said, you've got to think about what you're doing, mate. You're supposed to be working for the people, and I'm a peaceful man sitting down. And you've come throwing me about for no reason at all. And then the inspector's butted in with, he does a good job, he's just shaking you by the hand, he'll carry on doing exactly as I tell him to do. And I'm like thinking, like he's looking up at him, like all bright eyed, thinking, that's my boss. And it's like NLP in him, like, and I'm just thinking, what, you're telling me by throwing a man around with no reasonable grounds and the rest of it is... So I left it at that point. I just thought, you know, I may not see it firsthand, how they deal with it.
Yeah.
It's like, some of them really are.
This is, it's like a bloody, like a virus now, to speak. We're with guys in South Wales last night. It's bloody good. The small group phoned me up and they said they were interested in the suicides in Bridgend, which we've been watching for, it's over 40 now.
Are they still going?
They
stopped popping up on that little box that sits in the
corner. They're going out, going, ooh, look at the eyes. Jump off a bridge.
They are, they're over 40 and the local papers and the press and the media have been asked not to report to prevent copycats.
Have we got... samples from around there?
Well, what these guys phoned me up and they said they're interested in it, and I said we're interested in it as well because we got some other people who are watching. And he said, we know what they're doing. And I said, okay, do you want to tell me? He said, they're brainwashing the kids. This is stuff that we started to see ages ago.
What, they're going out physically on the street?
No, it's all been done through... kids are being given creative dance and drama courses.
Yeah.
They're getting N.L.P. in
static
it.
Static dance and all the rest of it. Right?
And the thing, there's now N.L.P. practitioners who are talking, well, some of them have been talking to me for quite a while. So they're trained and they're saying, shit, we're using this stuff for good. And this is scary. We're now starting to see people. So I've got N.L.P. practitioners talking about stuff, how it works, what's been...
Do you know what? I've got to come up with a good phrase this weekend. Neuro-linguistic healing.
Yeah. Well,
that's what we should be doing.
Yeah.
It's like
you can use it for that, but we just got these idiots doing it. So these guys started talking about this, and then we met up with them last night, and they know a lot. And the thing that the NLP guys have taught me is that it's cumulative. The example he says, you buy new laptops, the bee's knees works, and then I'll have that little program, you put a little program on it, I'll have that screensaver, I'll have that game. And then
eventually,
2 years later, all of a sudden, your machine starts playing up. He said, your brain's the same. So you have a kid, the kid at seven years old gets a little dose of NLP. Maybe not next year, the year after he gets another little dose, and then another little dose, right? And these guys were showing us a video clip where the words of the song are, we are leaders, we must kill ourselves or we will lead a dysfunctional society. So the So the instruction in this video clip is to kill yourself, not anybody, if you are a leader. But that's what they're making these people into, future leaders. Common purpose.
This is a common purpose video, training video.
No, this is just a pop video.
Oh, right.
But in the pop video, the song is encouraging people to top
themselves.
Well,
the song's Party Like It's 90, Party Like It's the End of Your Life, and it's in all the songs.
Yeah.
I can't listen to the radio.
But we're now getting professional people, including policemen, calling in. They don't necessarily call the Plymouth office, they talk to other people out there, saying, we're seeing it. We've got colleagues that are not acting normally.
Do you think they have found. on purpose in places like all government departments, like councils,
yeah,
job centres?
Yes, yeah.
Yeah.
What about job centres, yeah?
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, I reckon they do it all. Yeah. Yeah. When I used to be...
People are telling me, you've been into job centres, that the people
in there getting
really aggressive.
Yeah, about breaking news.
Yeah, like you know, you're a piece of shit, what are you doing here? Yeah. And that's because it's reframing. It doesn't have to be common purpose, it's just the ideology.
Yeah, and I've spoken to many police constables, right, and when I've said to them...
Oh, you're doing, you're right, okay, good.
Because right, when they go on these high-profile protests, they're briefed before going on them, and then they're debriefed when they come off them, with people standing at the front, like a seminar, and anchoring them, and doing all sorts of stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's definitely... it's not come to an end.
But the key bit was to actually get some people to accept something weird was going on. And last night was bloody magic, because there's five guys. I did a little private talk to them, and then they're saying, we know this. And they're absolutely seeing it.
More people are like feeling and seeing stuff.
Yeah,
rather than
Aberdeen, if you go around this country at the moment, suicide rate's absolutely soaring. And this is not just people doing drugs or getting depressed, this is something different. South Wales, in the suicides, normally the girls take drugs or they cut their wrists or both, and it's boys who hang themselves. And what's happening is all of a sudden there's girls hanging themselves, so even the method of suicide's not normal.
Suicide's not normal, is it?
Well, but there's a document on the internet called the Soviet Art of Brainwashing. If you remember that, just put it into Google, you'll find it as a PDF. And if you read it, it's from Beera, is the man who wrote it, who's the Soviet head of. And it's talking about destroying Western democracies. We need to make suicide a normal and accepted part of life.
You used to be in the Navy as well, didn't you?
Eh?
You used to be in the Navy.
Yeah.
You never worked anywhere near the Hermes, did you?
I've never been on board Hermes, but I've been at sea with Hermes around, but never been on board, no.
Yeah, probably works on that.
Eh?
Yeah, he's quite an interesting fellow as well.
Right, what's he doing now then?
He's very quiet life down in Kent,
right,
with wife, children, the rest of it.
He's done the establishment.
Well, the funny thing is, he used to. That's why I'm the way I am. Is because like he used to like be well into like UFOs and things like that.
Yeah.
And that's how I fell into sort of like the Brackets Truth movement.
Right.
So I've always had fascination for UFOs and things that were out there, and my parents were My mum, she was like well into Egyptology and runes and things like that. So I just sort of like gradually sort of like found my own path and found myself like here where I am today.
Yeah.
And I even question what I'm doing sometimes.
Yeah, well, I'm going to say I'm really through the hump now. Well, one stage, you know, you'd occasionally wake up and you think, what the fuck are you doing? and then, you know, that's the matrix trying to pull you back in, and then the next minute you got through that.
I was like that 2 weeks ago. I was ready to go, right, bollocks, I want to give up everything I'm doing, because the people I think that I'm helping come along and want to.
And then they bite your hand.
Yeah. It's just like,
yeah, anyway. But that's that.
And then
is,
I thought, who the fuck are you? I don't know you, you're not. Long time, mate, or if you just come in and destroyed my brain in a matter of weeks, the solution here is fuck you off.
Yeah.
I don't want to have anything to do with you, mate. No. I don't resonate well with you. So please step away from me.
That's the way we do it. Yeah. You get on, you work with the people you get on with, and if you don't get on with them, you just. I try not to fall out, but if somebody I really don't like them or don't trust them, you just gently just ease away from them.
I think I've done very, very well over this one guy. It's just like I could have like flipped. And it's very manipulative, and I just thought, no, the only thing I could do is just walk away from him and bite my tongue, and I was like,
Joanne.
And then when I worked it out, I was just like, oh, I just can't be your friend, you don't resonate well with me.
Yeah.
And he's writing me like little notes saying, I want to be your friend, I miss being your friend. Like, I'm not 12 years old.
Yeah.
And then on top of that, he's doing that for show for everyone else, and I was just like, why would you want to be my friend, you know what I mean, if you do nothing but be negative and try and pull me down.
Yeah. So well, they are the dangerous people, because, you know, they just...
They don't know who the fuck he is. Anyway, pleasure.
You guys
know how...